Hello friends, good afternoon and welcome to Reset Live Lectures. Dear friends, as you know that we have started a series on polynuclear hydrocarbons and heterocyclic compound, and today we are conducting yet another lecture in the same series. In today's lecture, we will try to understand diazines and seven-membered heterocyclic compound. In this lecture, we will try to understand its properties and its preparations. To discuss this topic, we have with us our subject expert, Dr. Sushila Singhal. Dr. Singhal is Assistant Professor in Department of Chemistry in Deshpande College, University of Delhi. Without further ado, I would like to welcome ma'am to our studios and request her to start the lecture. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, Amitji. Good day to all viewers. Till now, we have studied the six-membered compound with only one heteroatom. Today, we will discuss about the heterocyclic compounds in which we are having six-membered ring with the two heteroatom. These heterocyclic compounds are called as diazines. These diazines can have nitrogen, oxygen and sulfur as different heteroatoms. But nitrogen will be present in all the three. One of them is the diazine in which we are having both nitrogen atoms. They can be present at different positions. So today we will discuss about these diazines introduction. One of this diazine, that is pyridiazine, its occurrence and its importance, its preparation from malic anhydride, from 1,4 dicarbonyl compounds and from 1,2,4,5 tetrazines. Then we will discuss their chemical properties and fused pyridiazines, two derivatives, one of them is cinoline and one is thalazine. And in the second module, we will discuss about the second diazine, which is called as pyrazine, its preparations and its properties, then the diazines with the oxygen, which is called as oxazine, and with sulfur, which is called as thiazine. And also we will study the seven-membered heterocyclic compounds. One of them is azepine, oxypine, and thiepine. So starting with the diazines, these diazines are six-membered heterocyclic rings containing two heteroatoms. These are derived from benzene by the replacement of two of the ring carbon atoms by heteroatoms. Three isomeric diazines are possible with the nitrogen atoms in which both heteroatoms are nitrogen. They can be present at 1,2 position, which is also called as orthodiazine. They can be present at 1,3 position, and that is also called as metadiazine. And these nitrogen can be present at 1,4 positions, and now they are called as paradiazines. And these are also named, the first one is pyridiazine, second one is pyrimidine, and third one is pyrazine. The second structure we have discussed in one of our previous lectures. So today we will discuss here the 1,2 and the 1,4 diazines. The corresponding benzo derivatives of these compounds are also known. One of them is cinoline, one is quinoazoline, one is quinooxaline. These are the three structures in which the other heteroatom is oxygen. If it is present at 1,2 position, it is 1,2-oxaline, it can be 1,3-oxaline, and it can be 1,4-oxaline. So first member is pyridazine. This is the pyridazine structure in which both nitrogen atoms, they are present at adjacent positions. It is a heterocyclic organic compound with the molecular formula C4H4N2. It contains a six-membered ring with two nitrogen and it is aromatic. It do not occur naturally. It is a colorless liquid with a boiling point 207 degree centigrade. It is miscible with water as well as with benzene. These two are the resonating structures of pyridazine, and these two contribute to the resonance hybrid. Here you can see that only the alternating positions of double bond has been changed in these two structures, and resonance energy of these two structures is estimated to be 12.3 kilojoule per mole. Now if we reduce these diazines, then we can get six possible structures, but only three structures are known. One of them is 1,2 dihydropyridazine, one is 1,4 dihydropyridazine, and one is 4,5 dihydropyridazine. It is a weak base and it forms monocation with acid. Electron donating groups augments its basicity. Thus, 4-methyl pyridazine has a pKa value of 2.92. It also possesses high dipole moment of value 4 dB. This rather high value of dipole moment is attributed to the fact that 2 nitrogen atoms in this molecule are located on the same side of the ring. Therefore, there is a greater pull of electrons towards the nitrogen, resulting in the high dipole moment. Then comes its occurrence and its importance. These structures are rare in nature, possibly reflecting the scarcity of natural occurring hydrazines. These are common building blocks for the synthesis of many heterocyclics. The structure is popular among pharmacophore, which is found within a number of herbicides such as cladazine, minaprine and hydralazine. These compounds are of little importance since they are not present in many natural products. But one of them, that is malic acid hydrazide, is used as a selective plant growth inhibitor. The structure of this malic acid hydrazide has been shown here. Now comes its synthesis. It can be synthesized from malic anhydride. The reaction is a condensation reaction in which this malic anhydride and its derivatives also, they can react with 1,4-dicarbonyl ethane butanoloid or dihydrofuran derivative, resulting in the pyridazine ring. The intermediate formed is refluxed with the phosphorus oxychloride to give the dichloropyridazine, which on subsequent dehalogenation with hydrogen and palladium carbon, which yield the final product. It may be noted that no dione intermediate formation takes place in the above reaction, but a dione is initially formed when a substituted malic anhydride is employed, and it can be seen from this example. Here you can see that we have taken the substituted malic anhydride. First it undergo refluxing with the hydrazine and it forms this intermediate which is called as dione. Then it will react with phosphoryl chloride to give dichloro substituent, and finally on dehydrogenation will give the 4-ethyl-5-methyl pyridazine. Gamma keto acids may instead be employed as the starting material to prepare this pyridazine. Here we have taken gamma keto acids instead of malic anhydride and we have reacted it with the hydrazine, and we get this intermediate which on bromination in the acetic acid will give the other intermediate, which on decarboxylation and then again repeating the same steps which we have done in the last reaction, that is by reaction with the phosphoryl chloride followed by dehydrogenation, and we will get the pyridazine molecule. These can also be prepared from 1,4-dicarbonyl compound. It is a one step cyclization from 1,4-dicarbonyl compound. This is the 1,4-dicarbonyl compound. It reacts with hydrazine and we get here the pyridazine. But this 1,4-dicarbonyl diketo compound can be prepared from furan. This is the substituted furan. When it reacts with the acetic acid, first it gives a substituted structure of furan. Then it reacts with acetic acid in the presence of dioxane, and from here we will get the 1,4-dicarbonyl compound, which finally will give us the pyridazine molecule. A useful modification of this method is the use of hydroxyl 1,4-diketone, such as 3-hexanol-2,6-dione, which is condensed directly with hydroxylamine to give 3,6-dimethyl pyridazine. These pyridazine can be prepared from 1,2,4,5 tetrazines. This is the 1,2,4,5 tetrazine. When it undergoes cycloaddition with the acetylene or substituted acetylene or alkene, it will result in the formation of pyridazine via a intermediate which is the enamine. The reaction has been shown by Saucer and co-workers and we will get here the substituted pyridazine by the removal of one nitrogen atom from this molecule. Here rearrangement will take place and this nitrogen will go out and we will get the pyridazine molecule. Treatment of 3,6-diphenyl-1,2,4,5-tetrazine, this is the 3,6-diphenyl-1,2,4,5-tetrazine, when it reacts with aldehyde or ketone with a base at room temperature, it will also give us a pyridazine via a intermediate formation in which a first ring opening is there and then it will undergo ring cyclization. After the removal of water, we will get here the substituted pyridazine. Now comes its chemical properties. It can react with acids. It is a weak base and thus it forms salts with the mineral acids. The protonation of the second nitrogen atom is difficult in this case because of the high energy required to generate the two positive charges on the adjacent nitrogen atoms. So only one of the nitrogen atom in the pyridazine will undergo reaction with the acid. Now comes a quaternization reaction. This ring also reacts with alkyl halides to furnish the monoquaternary salts, though less readily than pyridine. In case of pyridine, we are having only one nitrogen. So here in this case, we are having two nitrogens. So it will react less readily as compared to the pyridine. The position of the monoalkylation is influenced by the presence of alkyl group present on the ring. You can see in the reaction, we are having the methyl group on the pyridazine ring. It will react with the methyl iodide on heating and we will get the methylation on the nitrogen, one of the nitrogen, and here quaternization will take place at one nitrogen atom. Then comes the electrophilic substitution reaction. Since it is an aromatic compound, pyridazine itself is resistant to electrophilic substitution and can undergo reaction only under drastic conditions. No sulfonation, no nitration has been reported in this compound, but bromination in acetic acid is used for dehydrogenation of reduced pyridazine. Its substituted products may be prepared via one oxide formation. So first this pyridazine will react with this per acid and it will first form the one oxide, then it will undergo electrophilic substitution reaction and we will get here the substituted product. Here we are getting the 4-amino pyridazine via one oxide formation. These pyridazine rings can also react with nucleophilic reagents. The diazines are in general very susceptible to the action of nucleophilic reagents. The effect of the presence of a second nitrogen atom is to make the carbon atoms of the ring even more electron deficient than they are present in pyridine. So, aminopyridazines are prepared by the direct replacement of the halo group with concentrated ammonia or amines. Here this is the pyridazine ring. It will react with N-butyl lithium in the presence of ether and here nucleophilic attack will take place and we will get here the 3N-butyl pyridazine molecule. This pyridazine also reacts with alkyl lithium and Grignard reagents also at room temperature. This is the pyridazine. It will react here with the Grignard reagent and this Grignard reagent will add on the nitrogen atom and we will get here the finally alkylation of this pyridazine. Alkyl pyridazine also undergo condensation reaction added by weak bases. Then comes a reaction with the oxidizing and the reducing agents. Pyridazine is resistant to the attack of oxidizing agents because of electron deficiency in the ring. Since two nitrogen atoms are present and nitrogen atoms are electron withdrawing atoms, so they will reduce the electron density in the ring and we will get the less electron deficiency. We will get the electron deficiency in the ring. So with hydrogen peroxide only, they will form the N oxide. And here you can see in the reaction that after a reaction with the per acid, we will get only one of the nitrogen to make the N oxide. the oxidation will not take place at both nitrogens. So we will get here the only this product. The N oxide on treatment with silver nitrate and an acid chloride results in the formation of 3 nitropyridazine 1 oxide. The proposed mechanism involves the formation of acetyl nitrate, which decomposes to give nitronium ion, and these diazines are readily reduced. The ring can be easily cleaved when the two nitrogens are adjacent. The ring can be reduced also with the help of sodium and methanol. Here you can see that this substituted pyridazine, it reacts with the sodium and the methanol, and here the ring is completely reduced and we are getting here the reduced product. These diazines can also undergo photochemical reaction or irradiation of sunlight. These pyridazine, they undergoes photochemical rearrangement to make pyrazine. So here you can see that in the reactant we are having the nitrogen on the adjacent atoms, but after going the photochemical reaction via free radical mechanism, it converts into the product in which we are having the nitrogens at the para position, and we are getting this pyridazine has been converted into pyrazine. These also undergo adduct formation, pyridazine. It gives 1-2 adduct with the malic anhydride at room temperature. This is a pyridazine. It reacts with 2 molecules of malic anhydride and it gives a adduct. So adduct formation also takes place in pyridazine. Then comes the fused pyridazine. This pyridazine ring can be fused into a benzene ring in 2 ways. Fusion can be take place at the 3-4 position. Here the fusion is at the 3-4 position and the product will be the xenolene, and this fusion can be at the 4-5 position and we will get here the thalazine. This xenolene is a pale yellow solid with the melting point 25 degree centigrade. It is a weak base and it forms salts with the hydrochloric acid and the picric acid. It is toxic also. It can be prepared from 2 amino phenyl propiolic acid via intermolecular cyclization to the of the diazonium salt. So first of all, diazonium salt has been prepared from NaNO2 in the presence of HCl. So diazonium salt will be formed, then it will undergo hydrolysis to make the intermediate compound, which after removal of a proton will finally form a xenolene. Xenolene can also be prepared from Bosch synthesis. It involves the cyclization of diazotized 2 amino acetophenone. This reactant is diazotized acetophenone. First it will undergo rearrangement, then in the presence of acid it will finally form the xenolene. The next fused pyridazine is the thalazine. It is again a pale yellow solid with the melting point of 90 degree centigrade. It is having a characteristic odor and is readily miscible with water. It is also weakly basic and forms salts with acid as that of pyridazine. It is somewhat more reactive than pyridazine and has been found to undergo direct electrophilic substitution. Now comes its preparation. It can be prepared by heating tetrachloroorthoxylene and hydrazine. This reactant is tetrachloroorthoxylene. When it reacts with hydrazine, it directly condenses and will give us the thalazine by the removal of 4 molecules of hydrochloric acid. This thalazine can also be prepared by condensing thalidomide or its derivative such as dibenzoyl ketone. This molecule is dibenzoyl ketone. When it reacts with hydrazine, water will go as a side product and these 2 molecules will condense together to give the thalazine. Now comes its properties. Thalazine on oxidation with monoperoxythalic acid at 0 degree centigrade will yield thalazine 2 oxide, while vigorous oxidation in the presence of potassium permanganate will give thalazine 4-5-dicarboxylic acid. These thalazines on reduction with sodium amalgam results in the 1, 2, 3, 4 tetrahydrothalazine. Here one of the ring has been reduced, while when it reacts with zinc in the presence of mineral acid, that is hydrochloric acid, it undergoes ring opening and we are getting here the only one ring, and the side ring has been opened in this case. Now the second molecule is pyrazine, one of the intermediate compound, which is the one, this is the 1,4 isomer of diazine. It is a colorless solid with a melting point of 54 degree centigrade. It is a symmetrical molecule as the two nitrogen atoms occupy the 1,4 position. It is a weaker base than pyridazine and pyrimidine. Pyrimidine we have discussed in the previous lectures. It has zero dipole moment because of the symmetry in the molecule. Since the molecule is symmetrical, so there will be no charge separation and the molecule will have the zero dipole moment. This pyrazine molecule may be represented as a resonance hybrid of following these four structures we have shown. Many more structures can be drawn for this pyrazine, and the resonance energy of this molecule has been calculated to be 24.3 kilojoule per mole. Although the various dihydro and tetrahydropyrazine are also known, but the most important reduced product is hexahydropyrazine, which is also called as pyrazine, and it has its importance in the alkaloids. This pyrazine occurs naturally, though not in appreciable amount, but several polycyclic derivatives of pyrazine ring systems are known. One of them is pyridine ring. This is the pyridine ring in which we are having the pyrazine. This is the pyrazine, and this pyridine ring itself is present in the folic acid. This is the folic acid. Here you can see that this pyridine ring system is present in this folic acid. This is the phenazine. Here also we are having the pyrazine nucleus in itself in phenazine. There are pyrazine derivatives which are natural products and are useful as antibiotics, diuretics and anti-tumor agents. Few examples we have shown here. One of them is aspergillic acid. This is the aspergillic acid in which pyrazine nucleus is present. It is acting as an antibiotic. One of them is chlorocyclazine. This is the chlorocyclazine in which we are having pyrazine. It reacts with antihistamine. Now comes the synthetic methods of pyrazine. These pyrazine can be prepared from 1,2 diketones. This method involves condensation of 1,2 diketone with 1,2 diamine, yielding an intermediate dihydropyrazine. This is the intermediate. You can see in the reaction that this 1,2 diketone, first it will react with, it will condense with diamine, it will undergo refluxing, and water will go out and the molecule will cyclize to give this intermediate, which is called as dihydropyrazine. This dihydropyrazine then undergo oxidation to the corresponding pyrazine with the help of copper chromite at 300 degree centigrade. It is a general method for the synthesis of pyrazines. Many pyrazines, many substituted pyrazines can be prepared from this 1,2 diketones. These pyrazine can also be prepared from alpha amino carbonyl compounds. This method involves a self condensation of two molecules of alpha amino carbonyl compounds to yield 2,5 dihydropyrazine. So first of all, we have to prepare alpha amino carbonyl compounds, which we can prepare from this molecule with the reaction with the stannous chloride or zinc acetic acid. Then these two molecules will undergo self-condensation in the presence of a base, and water will go out to give the substituted pyrazine, which then undergo oxidation to give us the final product of pyrazine. Pyrazine can also be prepared from alpha amino acids. Alpha amino acids and their esters, they normally undergo a facile dimerization to the corresponding 2,5-dioxo pyrazines, which can be converted to substituted pyrazines. So here you can see in the reaction that we have taken here the two molecules of alpha amino acids. This is the alpha position in which we are having this amino group. So it is a alpha amino acid, and we have taken here the two molecules which will undergo dimerization to give us a cyclic product, which is 2,5-dioxo-piperazine. Then it will react with a reagent to give us the substituted pyrazine. Wolf et al., they also synthesized pyrazine from chloroacetal by reacting it with the ammonia. Here we have taken the chloroacetal. When it reacts with ammonia, it will make this intermediate product, which followed by acidification in the presence of hydrochloric acid and on heating and reaction with hydroxyl amine will finally give us the pyrazine. First of all, this structure is formed, which is 2,6-dihydroxymorpholine. Then this morpholine, this substituted morpholine, will finally react with hydroxyl amine in the presence of acid and will finally yield the pyrazine. A convenient method of synthesizing pyrazine can also starts from ethylene oxide and ethylene diamine. This is the ethylene oxide and this is the ethylene diamine. This is a diamine. Both of these two reactant will react together to give a unstable molecule. This unstable molecule will immediately lose a molecule of water to give a cyclic product, which on reaction with air or on exposure to air will undergo oxidation to give the pyrazine. These pyrazine can also be prepared from azines. Azines are three membered compounds in which we are having nitrogen. So this is the azine molecule. This is the diphenyl azerine. In the presence of sunlight, it undergoes rearrangement to yield 2,3,4,5-tetraphenylpyrazine among other products also. Here we have taken the two molecules of azerine, which on reaction with sunlight will give us the substituted pyrazine. Now comes the chemical reactions of pyrazine. It can react with acids. Pyrazine is a monobasic compound and is protonated at N1. Diprotonation is possible only in the presence of strong acid. Otherwise, we will get protonation only at one of the nitrogen atom. These pyrazine, since they are heterocyclic compounds, they can undergo electrophilic substitution reactions. These aromatic compounds, the presence of two nitrogen atom, these deactivates the rings towards electrophilic attack. The presence of electron donating groups, however, facilitates the electrophilic attack, and this can be evident from the chlorination of 2-methyl pyrazine under milder condition to give the product. So, chlorination of this pyrazine can be seen. Then we will discuss the few more reactions in the second module. Thank you. Now discussing with the electrophilic substitution reaction, these pyrazine, they also reacts with the nucleophilic reagents. Pyrazine reacts similar to pyridine as in case of Chi-Chi-Babin reaction. These pyrazine also reacts with sodamide in the presence of liquid ammonia to give 2-aminopyrazine. The reaction is similar to Chi-Chi-Babin reaction of pyridine. Then 2-fluoropyrazine, it also undergo a facile reaction with sodium azide to give the 2-azide pyrazine. Here you can see that this nucleophilic substitution, this nucleophilic reagents, they attack on the second position of this pyrazine, and we are getting the final product, which is the 2-substituted pyrazine. Because of the inductive and the resonance effects of the nitrogen atoms, the protons attached to the alpha and the beta methyl carbon atoms are acidic and are easily removed by the strong bases. So the resultant carbonine, it undergoes typical condensation and alkylation reactions. For example, here you can see that we have taken the substituted pyrazine. It reacts with this molecule and it again undergoes Chichibabin reaction, and here also the substitution will take place at the 2 position, and we will get here the 2-substituted pyrazine. Then it will react with the alkyl halide in the second step, and we will get here the 2-alkyl substituted product, and this Chichibabin reaction will subsequently will convert into the alkylation reaction. Now comes a reaction with the oxidizing agents. Pyrazine is stable to the action of oxidizing agents. The alkyl group present on the ring can be oxidized to the carboxyl group. This pyrazine itself has been converted to di N oxide with trifluoroacetic acid directly. The N oxide formation of substituted pyrazine with hydrogen peroxide in the presence of trifluoroacetic acid or per acids takes place on the most basic and the least sterically hindered nitrogen. Thus, 3-chloropyrazine yields exclusively the 4-oxide. Here you can see in this reaction, first N oxide is formed, and in this case, and in the second reaction, if we are having the chloro substitution, then the oxidation will take place at that position which nitrogen is less hindered, and here we will get this product in which we are having no chloro or no substituent nearby nitrogen atom. Then comes the oxidation of 2-chloropyrazine on the other hand takes place at the nitrogen atom adjacent to the chloro group in the presence of carose acid, and this carose acid is peroxysulfuric acid in the presence of sulfuric acid. In the last reaction we have seen that oxidation has taken place at this nitrogen, but in the presence of carose acid the oxidation will take place at the nitrogen which is nearby the substituted carbon. So here we will get the 2-chloropyrazine N oxide, this product. Then sodium perbromate, it yields a mixture of oxide when this substituted pyrazine, this dimethyl pyrazine, it reacts with sodium perborate in the presence of acetic acid. Here we are getting the two products, mixture of these two products, in which one of the product is in which oxidation takes place only at one nitrogen, and the second product in which we are having oxidation at both the nitrogen atoms of the pyrazine. Now, similar to pyridine and oxide, the pyrazine and oxide also reacts with acetic anhydride on warming. In the case of alkyl substituent, the nature of the product is a function of location of the substituent. Here you can see in this reaction that this this methyl group is present at a somewhat far to the N oxide position. When it reacts with acetic anhydride on heating in the presence of 10% NaOH, the oxidation will take place at this position, and we will get here the 2-hydroxymethyl pyrazine. But if we are having the 2-methyl N oxide pyrazine, and now we will react with the same molecule, this molecule with the same reagents, that is acetic anhydride, in the presence of 10% sodium hydroxide, then we will get here the different product, which is the 4-methyl-6-pyrazinone. So, by changing the position of the substituent, if we are taking the substituent at the 2 position, we are getting a different product, and if we are taking the substituent, this methyl substituent, at the 3 position of pyrazine and oxide, then we are getting here the 2-hydroxymethylpyrazine By changing the substituent position, we will get the different products in case of pyrazine. Then comes the formation of 2,3 pyrazine. Brown and co-workers, they examined the flash photolysis of pyrazine 2,3 dicarboxylic anhydride and identified an isomeric mixture of malonyl and fumonyl amongst the products. This led them to suggest a mechanism involving the fragmentation of an intermediate which is a 2,3 pyrazine. So here you can see that in this reaction the flash photolysis is taking place here, and we are getting an intermediate in which we are having a triple bond, and this is a type of benzene type of intermediate, and since two nitrogens are present here, so it is a 2,3 pyrazine this intermediate first formed. Then it will convert into the product, one of them is malonyl and one of them is fumonyl. So formation of pyrazine intermediate is following the mixture of these two products. Then these pyrazine, they also undergo photochemical reactions. Pyrazine ring is isomerized to other diazines under photolytic conditions. For example, 2,6-dimethyl pyrazine is isomerized to 2,5-dimethyl pyrimidine and 2,4-dimethyl pyrimidine. So here we are getting the two isomeric products by the photochemical reactions. Now comes the next six-membered heterocyclic compound in which we are having two heteroatom, but one of the heteroatom is nitrogen and other one is the oxygen. These are called as oxazines. It contains a six-membered ring with one nitrogen atom and other is the oxygen atom, and these are also aromatic compounds. Amongst the most important oxazine, one of them is morpholine, which is also called as tetrahydro-1,4-oxazine, and one of them is phenoxazine. Here you can see in the reaction that this molecule is morpholine. It can be prepared from ethylene oxide in the presence of ammonia. When ethylene oxide reacts with ammonia, first they forms diethanol amine, then in the presence of 70% sulfuric acid they forms the morpholine heterocyclic compound by the removal of one water molecule. This morpholine is a strongly basic molecule having the basicity similar to the secondary amines. It is miscible with water in all proportions and is widely used as a basic solvent. Then phenoxazine is also the parent substance of number of dyes and is prepared either from orthoaminophenol and catechol or from 2-hydroxy-2-nitrodiphenylamine. So these phenoxazine can be prepared from these two reactions. One of them is from the phenol and catechol. These two undergo condensation to give the phenoxazine, and it can also be prepared from the 2-hydroxy-diphenylamine. In the presence of sodium hydroxide, it will directly give us the phenoxazine. Then the another six-membered heterocyclic compound with the two heteroatom. One of them is nitrogen and other heteroatom is the sulfur atom. These are called as thiazines. Phenothiazine is the important member among the thiazines, and this thiazine can be prepared in two different ways. One of them is from the orthoaminothiophenol. This is the orthoaminothiophenol. When it reacts with catechol, it undergoes condensation with the removal of two water molecules. It will give us the phenothiazine. This phenothiazine can also be prepared from diphenylamine in the presence of sulfur. When this diphenylamine reacts with sulfur in the red hot tube, they also will cyclize at these two positions and we will get here the phenothiazine. This phenothiazine, it is also called as PTZ and is an organic compound that has formula as C6H4 whole twice NH. It is used in the chemical manufacturing as a stabilizer or inhibitor. In the mid 20th century, it is used as an insecticide and anti-helminthic for livestock and humans. Its derivatives are used in the field of psychiatry and allergy treatment. Methylene blue is a derivative of this phenothiazine, which is used in the cell staining experiment of biochemistry, of biotechnology, and in the oxidation reduction reactions. And it is also used as a indicator in chemical organic functional groups and in dyeing cotton. Now comes the 7-membered heterocyclic compounds. The 7-membered heterocyclic compounds containing one heteroatom are the heterocyclic analogues of 1,3,5-cycloheptadiene. There are 3 members. One of them is azepine, one is oxypine, and one of them is thiapine. X-ray crystallography has shown that these molecules are known planar molecules and they behave as polyenes. They do not comply with the Huckel's rule of 4n plus 2 pi electrons and are thus non-aromatic and possesses a high reactivity. Here you can see that we are having 3 double bonds in the molecule. We are having the 4n plus 2 pi electrons, but since one of the position in these 3 double bonds is sp3 hybridized, so these are non aromatic compounds. And since these are non planar molecules and planarity is the one of criteria of the aromaticity. Now first member of this 7-membered heterocyclic compound is the azepine. This azepine can be drawn as a 4 tautomeric forms, namely 1H, 2H, 3H and 4H. This is the H which is present at the nitrogen. So, if it is present at the nitrogen atom itself, then it is called as 1H azepine. And if these hydrogens are present at the 2 position, 3 position and 4 position, then the different tautomers will be formed. Except the 3H azepine, none of the others has been isolated till now. The 1H azepine and the N-substituted 1H azepine are very unstable and they rearranges readily to the tautomeric form of 3H azepine, which has been also isolated. Now comes a synthetic method of azepine. One of them is from azerines. Azerines are potentially useful precursors for the synthesis of these heterocyclic compounds. An azerine on oxidation to cyclopentadienone, this is the cyclopentadienone, thermally affords the 3H azepine in excellent yields. This is the cyclopentadienone molecule. When it reacts with azerine in the presence of toluene on warming, on heating, it will first give this intermediate, which will then lose the molecule of carbon monoxide and will then rearrange this 6-membered structure, will rearrange itself into a 7-membered structure. It will undergo isomerization to give the substituted azerine. Then these azerine can also be prepared from phenyl azide. A phenyl azide on decomposition in boiling primary or secondary amine, they undergoes ring expansion to yield 3 azepine derivatives via benzazerine. The 2 diethyl amino 1H azepine tautomer is probably the intermediate in this reaction. So here you can see that this is the phenyl azide. It reacts with secondary amine, this is the diethyl amine, and it will make this intermediate. Then this 6-membered structure will rearrange into 7-membered structure. Then it will undergo isomerization to give us the azerine. And these azerine can also be prepared from nitrobenzene. Nitrobenzene by its deoxygenation with tributyl phosphine yields 2-alkoxy-3H azepine. This reaction requires a primary or secondary alcohol, but it fails in the presence of phenol. So here we have to take only the primary or the secondary alcohol we can take. This is the nitrobenzene. This nitrobenzene first it will react with tributyl phosphine in the presence of alcohol. It will undergo rearrangement and we will get here a 7-membered heterocyclic compound, which is a substituted azerene. Then comes the chemical reactions of azepine. One of them is reaction with acids. The N-carboethoxy 3H azepine, it reacts with acids resulting in aromatization, and it gives the N-phenyl carbamate, which is a resinous product. It is having a flexibility of the resinous, and the hardness of this, not the flexibility, a hardness of this resinous product. So here we have taken the N-carboethoxy 3H azepine. It will react with the acid and will undergo free radical mechanism, and this 7-membered ring on reaction with acid, it will convert into a 6-membered product, which is a N-phenyl carbamate, and it is a resinous product. Then another chemical property is the ring contraction. Here this 7-membered ring has been contracted into a bicyclic product. This azepine, it undergoes ring, photo ring contraction to bicyclic valence tautomers. These transformations are thermally reversible and occurs by an orbital symmetry controlled disrotatory electrocyclic process. The 2-methyl N-carbomethoxy azepine, for instance, yields 2-carbomethoxy 3-methyl 2-aza bicyclo 320-hepta-36-diene, a bicyclic product. So here this 6-7-membered ring of azepine in the presence of sunlight and methanol, they undergoes photo ring contraction, and they has been converted here into the bicyclic product in the 93% yield on photolysis. Then comes the Diels-Elder reaction of azepine. The N-carboethoxy azepine cyclo adds to 1,5-dicarbomethoxy 3,4-diphenyl cyclopentadienone. This is the structure of this molecule, which cyclo adds to N-carboethoxy azepine in the presence of benzene, a known polar solvent, at 80 degree centigrade. It converts into a cycloadduct. These two Diels-Elder, in case of Diels-Elder reaction, these two molecules will undergo adduct formation, and we will get this 6 plus 4 pi cycloadduct. Here you can see that this is the 6 4 pi cycloadduct. Then comes a hydrogen shift property of azepine. Azepine undergoes hydrogen shift. These hydrogen shifts are common in large and unsaturated rings. A series of 1,5 hydrogen shifts thermally allowed, they connects the 1H, 2H, 3H and the 4H isomers of unsaturated azepines, oxypines and thiopines also. Here you can see that this is the azepine molecule, and here this hydrogen is shifting from this nitrogen to the other carbon atoms, and we will get a mixture of, or you can say a series of the different isomers of azepine, the tautomers of azepine. Here we are getting the 3H, here structure is the 2H, and this is the 4H structure of azepine. So we will get a mixture of these isomers via a hydrogen shift property of the azepine. Then comes the oxypine. This oxypine is one of the 7-membered structure in which we are having the oxygen atom as a heteroatom. It is again a known aromatic compound and is known polar due to the large structure of the ring. This oxypine is an orange liquid with a boiling point of 380 degree centigrade. This oxypine exists in a rapid equilibrium with its valence tautomer, that is the benzene oxide, which is obtained by the epoxidation of the planar molecule or the planar benzene. So here you can see in the structures that it exists in the equilibrium, that this 7-membered structure is in equilibrium with the second structure, which is the benzene oxide, and it can be it can be prepared from the epoxidation of the planar benzene. Now comes a synthetic method of this 7-member heterocyclic compound with the oxygen heteroatom, that is the oxypene. This was first prepared by treatment of 1,2-epoxy-4,5-dibromocyclohexane. This is the molecule with the mild dehydrohalogenating agent. So first of all, we have taken here the benzene structure. This is the cyclic structure, which on reaction with the per acid, first it forms the oxide, then it will undergo bromination to give the dibromocyclohexane. This is the epoxy molecule of epoxy substituted epoxy dibromocyclohexane. Then this intermediate will react with the mild dehydrohalogenating agent in the presence of ether, and by refluxing the these two intermediates to these two reactants, then it will lose the two molecules of hydrogen bromide, and first this epoxy will convert into the this chloro derivative will undergo equilibrium, and then it will convert into a, it will rearrange itself, this 6-membered ring will rearrange into a 7-membered heterocyclic ring, that is the oxypin. The substituted oxypin can also be prepared in the same manner from the appropriate cyclohexa-1,4-diene. So this is the cyclohexa-1,4-diene derivative. This can also make the substituted oxypin. So here we will get the this methyl oxypin. This is the 2-methyl oxypin. So in this reaction, we can get here the substituted product. Then second method of preparation is the valence bond isomerization. The compound 1,2-divinylethylene carbonate on pyrolysis in the presence of lithium chloride as catalyst, it will transform the reactant into a mixture of cis and trans divinylethylene oxides respectively. So first of all, we have taken here the 1,2-divinyl. This is the 1,2-divinyl ethylene carbonate. It reacts with lithium chloride at 200 degree centigrade, and it is giving us the mixture of these two cis and the trans oxides. Then these both of these cis and the trans intermediate, they rearrange to the valence bond tautomers, that is the 4,5-dihydroxypin. So here we are getting the final product, 4,5-dihydroxypin. The next preparation method is from 1,6-10-aniline in the presence of non-polar solvents on silica gel, they rearranges to give the benzoxypin. This is the benzoxypin. In this product, this is a fused oxypin. This 7-membered oxypin is fused to the benzene ring. So this is a fused product, and these fused oxypin can also be prepared from this reaction. This oxypin, they can also be prepared from the benzene itself, but here we have taken the Dewar benzene, that is a structure which was designated for the benzene before the calculase structure. It was a Dewar structure in which we are having C6H6, but the structure is not like a 6-member ring, it is a bicyclic molecule. The epoxidation of this Dewar benzene with metachloroperbenzoic acid and subsequent photolysis of this epoxide will give the parent oxypin. So here this Dewar benzene, first it will react with this metachloroperbenzoic acid in the presence of dichloromethylene. It will first form the undergo epoxidation, will form a epoxy benzene. Then in the presence of sunlight, it will give a 7-member heterocyclic compound, which is a oxypin. Now comes the chemical reactions of this oxypin. These can also react with acids. Oxypins and its derivatives undergo facile, thermal and acid catalyzed rearrangement to phenols. via their arene oxide valence tautomers. So here you can see that on reaction with the acids, the 7-membered ring on heating with acid has been converted into a 6-membered ring. The use of this isotopic labeling reveals that these reactions are accomplished by 1,2-hydride migration. So here you can see that this reaction is appearing very simple, very easy, but this 6-membered ring, it undergoes 1,2-dihydride migration. The mechanism is very typical in this case, and we will get this rearranged product, which is a 6-membered substituted product. Then comes the Diels-Alder reaction. Oxypin reacts via its arene oxide valence tautomer with malic anhydride to yield the adduct, which is 4-phenyl-1-benzoxypine. This is the oxypin. It is a 7-membered structure, which is oxypin. First, it will undergo its isomeric form, which is a epoxy benzene oxide. Then this isomeric form, it will react with malic anhydride via a Diels-Alder mechanism, and it will give us a final adduct, a Diels-Alder adduct, which is a 4-phenyl-1-benzoxypine. Then comes the photochemical reaction of this oxypin. Photochemically, these oxypins is converted to 2-oxa bicyclo, that is the 320-hepta-36-diene. So here you can see that this 6-7-membered oxypin, in the presence of sunlight, it undergoes photochemical photolytic reaction, and it converts into a bicyclic product, which is a 2-oxa bicyclo 320-hepta-36-diene. Then comes the next 7-membered structure, which is having the sulfur atom instead of oxygen. It is called as thiapine. It contains 8 pi electrons. It is also non-planar and is anti-aromatic. Then comes its preparation. This thiapine, the substituted thiapine, can be prepared from 2,3,4,5-tetramethylthiophene. Here we have taken this tetramethylthiophene. When it reacts with dicycloacetylene, here we have taken the cyano-substituted acetylene. When it reacts in the presence of aluminium chloride and dichloromethylene, first they will form the bicyclic product. Then these two bicyclic product, they will rearrange itself. The bond shift will take place here, and these two bicyclic product will then convert into a 7-membered structure, which is called as substituted thiophene. Then comes the chemical properties of thiophene. The thiophene derivative is known to give the adduct on warming, while on pyrolysis they yields the tetramethyl thalonitrile. Here you can see in the reaction that this thiophene in the at 2 different temperature give us the 2 different products on reaction with the will undergo pyrolysis to give the different tetramethyl thalonitrile. Now, based on today's lecture, we are having few questions. One of them is, what are diazines? Write the different isomeric forms of all diazines. Write the synthetic methods of pyridazine. What is the importance of this pyridazine and pyrazine? What are the products formed on photolytic chemical reactions on these two diazines? How adducts are formed from these pyrazine? What are oxazines and thiazines? And write the few 7-membered heterocyclic compounds and discuss about their aromaticity. Thank you.
Dear friends, due to paucity of time, we have to stop our lecture here. On that note, we would like to thank Dr. Singhal for coming to our show and delivering this wonderful lecture. And thank you, dear friends, for watching our show. Stay tuned and keep watching. Thank you.